The government's dedicated COVID response team is being disbanded tonight amid Victoria's ongoing health crisis. Despite a new report showing fatal flaws existed well before the pandemic, Daniel Andrews insists COVID is the issue. State political reporter Mark Santamartino.
Under the pump and clearly under the weather.
It's not COVID. I've had about 10 RAT tests in the last 3 days. I have a cold.
The Premier defended workers and the system, which couldn't get an ambulance to 14-year-old Lydia Anseline in April as she suffered an asthma attack.
She's still not breathing!
Listen to me, OK?
Firefighters got to her Pakenham home first, 28 minutes after Lydia's family dialed 000.
People need to be aware of how the system is working.
Nothing we say here can bring that child back. No one's making excuses. We're just providing explanations. They're real. The pandemic is real.
Ambulance Victoria declared its sixth code red in 6 months this week. Back in April, then acting CEO Libby Murphy revealed delays may have contributed to the deaths of 21 Victorians since October.
I would say three attributable to Ambulance Victoria and 18 are relative to call answering.
But even before COVID, patients were dying. A damning study of 200,000 Victorians suffering chest pain between 2015 and mid-2019 found it was taking paramedics longer to offload patients at hospitals. Anything over 17 minutes was raising their risk of death, and 70 patients paid the ultimate price, despite ambulance response times improving to record highs.
The system was broken before COVID. COVID's made it worse.
If we're honest, the time at hospital is really challenging for them because what they want to be doing is out in the community responding to our patients.
This is not about money. This is all about staff. And if staff are sick, they can't go and work to provide care to sick patients.
Things are about to get a little tougher for staff before they get better, Pete. The deal that Ambulance Victoria had with Australia's Defence Force is set to expire tomorrow. Troops had been driving ambulances around, like student paramedics and surf lifesavers. The time is also up for Victoria's dedicated COVID-19 response team. That team will be disbanded with its responsibilities absorbed into the Department of Health tomorrow. There is one shining light. The Premier is hopeful that the $3,000 bonus on offer for public hospital staff and ambulances, half to be paid next month, the remainder in September, will keep staff around throughout the winter and hopefully encourage others back into the workforce. Pete.
Okay, thank you, Mark.